you could write a book about how you're going to turn retirement upside down.
I'll always remember those Dennis Hopper commercials, you know, the ones with the attitude about boomers challenging every preconception and notion about retirement.
Dreams are powerful. Dreams are what make you say, when I'm 64, I want to start a new business.
Since I started my career in the 70s on the road for Good Morning America, profiling people in the context of their work, I thought I'd take one more lap around the career track. But this time I'm focusing on people who've made interesting changes in their lives and their work, given the new social, economic priorities that are affecting our generation like none other. One of my dreams was to run off with a rock and roll band. And I finally got to do it just as I was turning 60, thanks to an invitation from Crosby, Stills, Nash and Young to embed in their reunion tour. One
morning, you guys, where is Mike? You made me nervous tonight. I've been thinking about everything I said to you.
Moving to a foreign country in midlife, taking on a whole new culture, a whole new language, a whole new literature.
Francis Mays, the author, was my first case study of boomers in transition and reinventing themselves. She very famously did so under the Tuscan Sun for a book she was writing.
This is a lot of fun, and I'm not retired. This is a full-time activity.
In Vermont, I met a fellow by the name of Barry Meinerth. Now, he was pretty smart. He worked on someone else's alpaca farm on the weekends for 4 years before literally buying the farm himself. And he made the transition from being a printing executive in New York City.
Here in Indiana, Fields of Dreams is less a cliche and more of a way of life.
Former Indiana Governor Joe Kernan's career change came somewhat unexpectedly after he lost his bid for re-election.
You know, baseball has always been there for me as a big piece of who I am.
Joe combined his passions for baseball and community affairs by taking over the South Bend Silverhawks, which was a struggling minor league baseball team in his hometown, which was also the key to its urban renewal plans.
At my age, what do you got to lose? Why not take a flyer every once in a while?
Cindy Joseph didn't think she had the looks, or more importantly, the self-confidence to be a model when she was younger.
What you see is what you get. I'm happy with it. If you want it, I'll sell it to you.
Now she's a top model in New York at the tender age of 59 and breaking all the age barriers about work by riding the silver tsunami that's sweeping over the marketplace for virtually every product.
My personal philosophy is play till your day you die. That would be a complete life.
Mickey Hart, a drummer for the Grateful Dead, told me about cutting short his education to pursue his music career, something that always bothered him. Now he's collaborating with Dr. George Smoot, the Nobel Prize-winning astrophysicist, on a soundtrack for the universe.
We're in the same business. Basically, it's vibrations.
If there's one common denominator I've discovered while doing these stories, it's that people at this age really want to give back and do something maybe a little bit more meaningful in their lives.
Isn't this a chain of hope?
Connie Duckworth, who was one of the first female traders at Goldman Sachs, left her finance career to start a women's rug cooperative in Afghanistan.
In these intractable world problems, again, small or large, just do something.
Bill Pinkney, a Navy vet and cosmetic salesman, raised money to buy a boat to be the first African American to sail around the world solo. He did it just to show inner city kids how far they could go with a basic education and a commitment.
The ultimate adventure is the easiest part. It's getting up to it that's the hard part.
Equally inspiring are those people who haven't had to change at all, like Yvon Chouinard, founder of Patagonia. He's really one of the true rock stars by continuing his work and living of protecting the planet and just doing things he enjoys.
The hardest thing in the world is to simplify your life. It's so easy to make it complex.
Hey, challenging social conventions and making up new ones along the way, nothing new for our generation. But now that we're getting our first Social Security checks and hopefully paying off the last of our tuition bills, watch out, it's going to get interesting.